When I started out, I pretty much inked everything with a brush. As the years went by, like I said, early on in my career, I started doing some stuff for Image, and the look that they were going for back then was like a real, like Scott Williams type of look, Scott Williams, Danny Mickey type of look, with everything was like sort of cross hatching like this with small pen strokes. So to emulate that with a brush was tough. So I taught myself how to ink with pens. And, I tried pretty much every type of pen I could find, but I settled down on, I guess, the industry standard is the Hunt 102, which is what I still use. At that time, I was probably doing, I'd say, 50-50 brush to pen. But as the years went by, brushes are like $20 a pop, and the quality of them varies wildly. So you could buy a brush for $20 or $25, and you get it home and it doesn't work, and you're out $25. Whereas a pen, they're like a dollar each. If it doesn't work, it's a dollar. You throw it aside and get another one. You can get a box of them for like $10, a box of 12. So what I did over the years is sort of by trial and error, I sort of figured out how to ink pretty much everything with a pen, which is what I use right now. I can fake it well enough where, like, the thicker lines here are pretty much all pen too, but its thin lines, are all pen too. But it gives it a different feel. Like this almost looks like a brush line, as opposed to this cross hatching stuff inside there. So how I do that is by I sort of have a rotation thing going where I have like two or three pens going at the same time where I'll have a really new one, a sharp one, to do all the really fine line detail, and then an older beat up one to do, most of the regular ink on the page, and then a really old one that's almost to the point of throwing it out, where I'll do all the big brushier strokes, because you can get like a fatter line with them, So between rotating all of them, which gets annoying at times, but it works out because it almost is like I'm inking with a bunch of different tools, where it's pretty much the same tool all the way through. The ink I'm always sort of changing because, like I was saying with the brushes, a lot of times it's hard to find quality because it seems like the companies change stuff as they go along. For instance, when I was in college, the stuff when I was inking everything with a brush, the brush stuff you used back then was called it was Higgins Black Magic ink, and Black Magic ink was so thick that there was no way you could put a pen in there and use it. If you put a pen in there and used it for a little bit, it would just clog, get dried and hard and everything. The quality's gotten to the point now where the Black Magic stuff is so watered down that I'm using it for a pen straight without anything else now. And for using it for a brush, it doesn't work because if you lay down a black with the brush with that Black Magic now with the brush and you erase it, the pencil mark underneath, all the ink will come up because they've watered it down so much. So it's a constant struggle now to find different inks that work for you. I mean, right now I've settled on this, it's called Black Star ink that Dr. Martens makes. And that gives you a pretty black, finish, but even that, it's constant struggle. I mean, everything, the quality of the pen nibs has gone down somewhat over the years because, in the past, if you bought a box of 12, probably eight or nine of them would be good. There'd be a couple of duds in there. Now it's like 50-50 at best. So, I'm sounding like a grumpy old man here, but everything is really sort of not as good as it used to be in my day. Even the paper is really kind of crappy lately. The paper I'm working on right now, the penciler found an old sheet from 10 years ago, and it works perfectly fine. The stuff that we're using now is not quite as good, and many of the pages bleed all over the place, which, makes it harder when you're trying to do really precise line work and it's spreading every time you put a line down. So, yeah, like I said, I'm a grumpy old man with this stuff.